Hi, my name is Cindy Rang.
I'm Brianna Motzkus, and today's our Sunday box opening.
Hi. All right, so I know that we promised we were going to change our view, and we will.
But we couldn't do it for this
one. We couldn't do it quite yet. We have to bring in a table.
We forgot the most important part.
A table.
A table.
Yeah. Yeah. So, next week for sure. Next Wednesday, we'll see Brianna. Also, the other thing that Anna pointed out is that we're in a fairly small area here. You can't really tell, but it's not really very big. So all of our
talking
with our arms is minimal because we're going to smack each other. So, yeah. So I know everybody's excited to see Tracy again. And if you're not sure what we're talking about, it was the video, the compilation video that Anna
That went up, I think, Tuesday.
Yeah, it was pretty funny. Mm-hmm. Yeah, it was good that she found all of those fun laughs. So that's good. And we're missing our joke of the day. Also, you know what we missed on Wednesday?
What?
Oh, I can't even believe it.
Daughter's Day.
It was Daughter's Day.
It's National Daughter's Day. We would have known that if we would have been standing in front of Tracy, and Tracy would have reminded us of that.
Yes.
I had a gift and everything. I guess we'll wait till next year.
It comes around every year. And there you go.
So, and if you don't know who we are, we're always supposed to start with this because every once in a while somebody new sort of wanders in and we find a new customer and a new viewer. So we are a mother-daughter duo. We have a quilt shop in Central Washington State. We've been here for 26 years and you can find everything online at fabricpatch.net or if you're in the area, we're in Ephrata. And we have a retreat center. We host retreats. We have the YouTube channel where we do classes and tutorials, and we do these box openings. So the box openings every Sunday afternoon at 12:30 and every Wednesday evening at 5, we show you brand new things that have just come in the shop. All of it's already online. You can go ahead and see it. And every once in a while we do special things where we'll show all kits or all clearance or all Christmas or whatever. But at the moment, I know today we have a whole lot of boxes. Mm-hmm. We're going to open a whole bunch of stuff. We're also going to, should we start with these?
Do you want to start with bra auction stuff?
We should start with bra auction stuff because the other thing we're doing is we have a bunch of different fundraisers that are near and dear to our heart. Mm-hmm. McKay Memorial is coming up soon. Just going to mention that. And we have a sweet little girl that we're going to host for Christmas. That will be coming up. More information about that later. But right now, it is all about bra auction. So 4 years ago, we started doing this, and it was to raise money for friends of ours that were affected with breast cancer. And what we wanted to do was just raise some cash, basically. We don't want to have to go through, you know, an agency or a clinic or the breast cancer research or the whatever. Mm-hmm. We just want to give our friends a check to spend in any way they need to spend it. It might be for prosthetics or a spa day or travel or because they've missed a bunch of work. We don't care. We just want to raise some money for them and send a special little card to say, we're thinking of you. We've all got you. You're in our prayers. And, you know, we're in this. Nobody fights alone.
Yes.
So this is our fourth year doing it. We have our 50 nominees. We are going to put their names on our website at some point as we get a little bit closer. First name and last initial only and where they're from. We have a couple people that have given us permission to tell their whole story and maybe feature their business a little. We really want to help them in every way that we can. And then what we're going to do is October 26th on a Saturday night, we're having a live auction. It'll be at 5 p.m. Pacific time. Mm-hmm. And we have people from all over donated stuff. And we're going to try to raise $50,000. Everybody seems to think we can do it. We raised almost $19,000 last year. It makes sense that we could double it.
Yeah.
And what we are going to do is the Wednesday before, so 3 days before, we're going to put up a buy now category. So if you aren't going to be around for the auction or that's too stressful to try to be the highest bidder, but I really, really wanted it, we'll have the, if you're the first one to buy now, you'll get that opportunity. And there'll be more about that. But we've been having so many great things come in and we thought how fun just to kind of feature them as they come in. We're a little bit behind. So if you have sent something and you haven't seen it yet, don't worry. It might have gotten other things piled on top, but anyway, we want to show you guys things and we'll have things kind of pictured on the website and the website is evolving a little bit, but
yes,
it's not too late. you can go ahead and send your items. If you go to our website, there is a special tab that says Bra Auction. There's a little drop-down bar, and you can check that out. And if you're going to donate something, you'll see in a minute, there is this little donation form.
Yes.
So you need to print that off, you need to fill that out, and it needs to accompany your item so we know what it is and whose it is. Oh, and words from the back.
If they're having any difficulty with come doing that, I'm happy to take a phone call.
Oh, good. Tracy's going to come around. I know that you guys don't always hear her back there. Tracy is fantastic. She's been checking everything in for us. She's been sending out sweet little thank you cards for everybody. And tell them again.
Well, I was going to say, those donation forms, if you're not savvy on the computer, because, you know, sometimes they can be challenging. So if you want to fill one out, I have paperwork here, and I'd be happy to take your information for a nomination or for a donation. Yeah. Just want to make it as easy as possible.
Yes.
Because want to get those
support.
Many wonderful
it's all about.
Things. Yes, yes, indeed. So anyway. Yeah.
Perfect.
I don't need to give you my phone number. You know how to get a hold of me.
Yeah,
email me. Give me your phone number. I'll call you. Or if you already have my phone number, just give me a call anytime.
And our phone is on, we're here. We're here most days, and we let the answering machine pick it up because we're filming or doing other things. But from 10 until 5 Pacific time, our phone number is 509-754-8280. You can leave a message. Tracy gets those. She's the one who listens to the messages.
Yes.
So again, super happy to help. And one more thing, we have a donation button. If you just want to donate cash, you know, give us your coffee money or, you know, whatever, there's a donate button and you can go right on there. And we're keeping track of all of those also.
Yeah.
And the last thing to mention is 100% of the money that we raise is going to be divided amongst the 50 people that we're raising the money for. There are no administrative fees, no percentages, no shipping, no credit card fees, none of that. We are sending every bit of it out. So anyway, all right. And so
we're going to start with some show and tell for donations. For the donations. So some things that you might find on the buy now when we get closer, or it'll be on the live auction. This was a handmade quilt made with love by Tara Fanning of at the Windy City Quilter using a Noel quilt pattern by Susie Quilt. Oh,
this is
the back.
Back.
Sorry.
I thought maybe you wanted to show that for me.
Yeah, I love it.
But let's look at that. That is really cute. It's little teapots. It's a teapot,
it is, right?
Oh, no,
it's an elephant.
It's an elephant.
It's an elephant.
It's an elephant.
A very healthy elephant.
Or it's a teapot.
He's short and stout.
Or. Yes, cute. That is adorable.
Super cute.
Wow. That is really well done.
And it's 48 by 48. So perfect for a nursery if you have a little person in your life. This is a great car quilt, floor quilt, grow into a little girl big bed, you know, out of the crib. It's a perfect size and perfect colors.
It is really well done. That I've been doing my best quilt police impression. And
it's beautiful.
Yeah. I mean, that is like spot on. That's fantastic. Beautiful.
Super cute.
And what a cute, you know, a lot of people are doing quilts out of, like, you know, 30s fabrics and, you know, vintage fabrics. Mm-hmm. And that would be a really cute baby quilt also. It has multiple
yes,
options.
I would. And it also comes with quilt care information.
Oh, really nice.
Which is super cool.
Aww.
So you'll know how to treat her right when she's yours.
And is this what is her website?
It was made by Tara Well, this is from Eloise. Eloise donated it.
Oh, gotcha.
But she got the quilt from Tara Fanning from the Windy City Quilter.
Oh, gotcha. Gotcha. Oh, I feel like I know Eloise.
Yes.
I know. It's funny. We get orders from different people and then we remember their names. And I had my Aunt Rusty, my favorite aunt, her real name was Eloise.
Eloise.
And you never hear that name very often. Yeah.
Okay, I'm excited about this one.
Oh, wow.
So I haven't actually seen it, but the donate is from Robin Luce. Super,
from
she
what?
Came Texas. She came
Wait,
in,
Texas.
Hung out. with us, but it is Halloween Witches with Ghastly Fabrics.
Ghastly I can't believe you're partying with your Ghastly Fabrics.
It's 48 by 62.
No longer available.
And she got this kit from a best friend's stash after she passed away unexpectedly. So she knows that she'd be very happy knowing that it is being used for such a great cause.
I'm so excited to see it.
I love the ghastly.
Let's look at the back. So look at these really cool trees. Trees.
Oh my gosh, look at that.
Oh my gosh.
And this is like a collector's quilt now, because Henry is no longer.
No longer.
Yeah.
They are, you cannot. Ghastly Fabric was a thing for a while and people collected it. I can't believe she's actually parting with some.
And the Alexander Henry Company is.
Yeah, gone.
And he passed away.
Nobody bought it.
Yep.
I love it so much.
Oh, I love the Ghastly. Oh, yes. Very nice.
So exciting. Robin, thank you so
very
much.
Very generous. Really nice. Fun. There's such a variety.
Yes.
So that's really the best thing, is that just so generous and so thoughtful. And somebody had emailed me this morning. I was looking at the emails and responding, and somebody had said, I'm not much of a quilter, but it was made with love. And isn't that what's important? I said, that's absolutely what's important is, you know, it's always the macaroni necklaces and,
absolutely.
You know, the kids' artwork and the quilts that are made with love. That's the most important thing. And you can tell, you know, it's just really nice. So I just love that it's.
These are awesome. So this is from Jennifer Philbrook from Olympia. Pink
was a two-word. Jennifer, generous. So
Jennifer
Philbrook from Olympia. She says the cork and black bag is a simplistic sling by Aura Rosa. It is 7 inches wide, 10 inches high, and 3 inches deep.
Look how cute that is. And look at the inside. Look at all of the, can you see? Wow. It's black, so you might not be able to see it, but there is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. There is 8 pockets for your credit cards on this side.
Mm-hmm.
There is a zipper pocket and then another cubby pocket on that side. And
awesome.
Look at the depth of it.
Yeah, that's really nice. Yeah. And it's a really nice sling, so you can wear a crossbody sling, however you feel most comfortable wearing it. That's a great bag.
It's a great bag.
Very cool. All that really cool hardware.
Yeah.
Badass.
And then what is
this? Okay, the pink bag is the Catalina Crossbody by also Aura Rosa. 11 inches wide, 7 inches high, 3 inches deep. I love that.
And then does she say, I sell these? So does she have a website?
I sell these. Oh, she does sell these. My inspiration is for my best friend who's battling breast cancer. Decided to make a bag that I would carry and one that she would carry.
These are fantastic. What is her website? Does she say anything?
She does not, but she has an email address. So if you're like, oh my gosh, sign me up.
My email here.
It is jphilbrook@hotmail.com. So if you are interested in purchasing a bag from her, send her an email and say, hey, I saw ya.
I'm going to check.
She watches us. So she
is quality work.
That is
look at
beautiful.
This. Look at the way. So I just want to turn it inside out so you can see her binding. Really well done. Those of you guys that did the bag class with us.
You know how impressive that is. That's a quilter's flex right there.
And look at this again. Look at, I don't know if you can see. Maybe if you are on that side. I don't know.
You can see inside?
Well, I just feel like it's worth seeing. Can you see how many cubbies?
Yeah.
Are in there for your cards, which is really nice. Because what's really nice is to have a bag that will double as your wallet, you know, and what do you need? You just need your cards and your lipstick and your lotion. And then there is the inside is tapestry, a thicker fabric. Nice. And then there's a nice zippered pouch right there.
Beautiful.
And
a handle. Oh, and a handle.
Oh, gorgeous. This is fantastic, Jennifer.
Right?
Thank you so much. Look at, she did the little quilt, and this is out of that faux leather.
That's normal.
Yeah,
fabulous job.
And there's a pocket on the outside.
Put your massive phone out there.
Fantastic.
Love it. Jennifer, these are fantastic.
And Jennifer, if you wanted to, in the comments, put your Etsy site or your website, or if you custom, whatever. Put some information. We're all going to search the comments for.
Yes. We want to know.
Fantastic.
Wow. Gorgeous.
I love the diversity.
I do too.
I love that there's just multiple quilts and table runners and
bags, all kinds of things.
I think it's great.
We're going to do, is this one?
No, I was going to do
this one?
The bag.
This one is from Tanya.
Ooh.
So I know how I would say it.
Would you say it like that? The gay is silent.
Nipple bird.
That's what I would say too.
Love it. From Kaloops, British Columbia.
How would you say her name?
My guess is it's not Nippleberg. It's because she's Canadian. So my guess is they're going to pronounce they
K-N-I-P-P-E-L-B-E-R-G.
Maybe they pronounce the K too.
Knipple. Knipple. You're going to have to phonetically tell us.
That is an awesome name.
It is.
That is an awesome name.
I love it.
I love it.
It's perfect.
It's so perfect. So the pattern is Strawberry Swirl by Fig Tree and Company.
Ooh, beautiful.
The fabric is Cottage Blue by Robin Pickens.
Cottage Blue fabric went so fast here at the shop.
Super fast. And she says she has Minky backing.
And it's 60 inches square.
And then she has a little note to us. Hope you'll be able to use this quilt to support your fundraising bra auction. I started quilting during COVID found your YouTube channel soon after. Oh, countless hours of inspiration and entertainment. Thank you both. Tanya, thank you so much. Thank you. All right. Oh, look at the back.
Look at all that quilting.
Luscious blue.
The quilting is beautiful.
Yeah, look at that. You can see the quilting a little bit easier on the back. Can you see it? I don't know if they can.
The quilting is gorgeous.
Really, really nicely done. Beautiful.
So navy blue back, minky back. And look how pretty this is.
Wow. That's fantastic. Oh, she has a little label.
Oh, love that.
What does her label? Tanya Nippleberg, handmade.
Cute.
I love it.
I love that too.
Wow.
Oh, it is perfect.
Wow. That is really, really nice.
That is super cool.
I just love that.
Beautiful.
Really, really nice.
Tanya, thank you. Beautiful really job.
Well, really, really well done. What a nice variety.
Yeah.
Okay, so remember, put this on your calendars, check things out. Come to the website and check out on Wednesday. What we'll do is we'll talk about it Wednesday morning during Fabric Chat, and then we'll tell you, remind you about the things that will be online, because I think what we'll do is we're going to turn them on at a certain time so that you can rush and see which things you could do to buy now. I'm going to warn you, we're going to price them
fundraiser prices.
Yeah, they're not going to be yard sale prices or gosh, we need to, get rid of some stuff. It's fundraiser prices. Yeah. So be prepared for that. But then because we just think we have too many things to do in the live auction, so we'll have some buy now. Mm-hmm. We don't have a way to do a silent auction.
Yeah, we've tried that 1 year, but they took so many administration fees that it seemed like it wasn't quite
We didn't want to give money to those people, so we think we're going to do it this way. So anyway, we'll have more details.
I am planning to hopefully get a newsletter out next week. So a fabric patch newsletter. So go to the website, click newsletter, and you can sign up for it if you're not already signed up for it. Or you can find it there. Later. Yeah. But I am hoping to do a newsletter that's kind of just going to fill out the quarter for us. So we know what's going to happen throughout the end of the year. It'll have a whole page about the breast cancer auction that we're going to do. So you'll have dates and times and things to make sure you put on your calendar. Tell your friends. Tell all your neighbors and whatever people are thinking who ask you all the time, oh, can I buy a quilt from you? Oh, can I buy a quilt from you? And you running out of time, we're not quilting as much anymore, tell them to take a look.
Yeah.
One, it's a good cause. Two, they'll probably find something they would love to snuggle with.
And if you want to share it on your Facebook page,
yeah.
Or share it with your guild or whatever, but go to our Facebook page and it's shareable. And you can share, we have kind of a fun little post with the information and yeah. the link to our website and even the donate now button. So, so share all of that. The more people that participate and watch and bid and just hit the donate now button,
yes.
The closer we can get to our 50,000. So
yes. Love it.
We're excited about that.
All right.
Okay. Okay, stay tuned for more. Yes. So those are just four of the ones. And then with each box opening and each Fabra chat episode, we're sharing a few more, which is really kind of nice and gets you guys to be able to see all of them up close. And right, and then I wanted to say, I'm not sure that we mentioned, did a little shout out for Sue Mays. Sue Mays sent the cutest little handmade pumpkins.
Oh yeah, we showed them.
Did they see
and them? Then I said,
oh good.
Sue, I took some pictures of Maze with her pumpkins.
Oh good.
And Tracy's gonna email me pictures.
Oh good, good, good. Because sure. I was hang on to cards to remind to get a thank you card out. And it's like, oh shoot, I hope she knows that we got those. And
yeah. Maisie really nice. Loves the pumpkins.
She does.
Yeah.
And she loves that couch.
That couch.
Loves that couch. Won't let anybody sit on it.
Yeah. No.
No.
Except today she's out there with it. It's rolled out. She has it rolled out and she's laying on it with her baby, which is actually her puppy.
Her puppy.
And then Auntie let her play with Aurora's baby doll. So they're both, all three of them are sitting there.
Yeah. Just lounging.
Lounging. Eating goldfish.
Yes. Yes. All right. So a couple of local things we wanted to share with you. Oh, one is Laura Estes. A lot of you guys know her. There's this pillow that we've seen many times, and then also the one that's just all of the little blossoms. She's fairly local. I mean, it's Odessa, which is about 45 minutes from here. And she's the one who has designed all of these little ruching tools. We have two different videos. One is a trunk show, and one is
a demo,
a tutorial about how to use her tools. This is the other one. We have two of these pillows in the store, this pink one, and then we have one made out of some fall fabric. So super, super popular. Anyway, just a quick little shout out. We have been out of some of the full bundles,
yes.
but those are now, you can get the tools that you need or just the one tool. But if you want a bundle, we put a bundle together of five of her tools, which you then get at a discount. The bundle price is a discounted price, plus a free package of her favorite needles, which is the Milner size 7. And we put in a little flower made specially by her. So
Laura makes us little posies
every time. And so we put in just a special little flower that you can have, that you can put on whatever you'd like to put on. So
cute.
Made by the master.
Yeah.
So anyway, so these are back in stock. You'll find those. And does she have a special category?
Yes,
Laura.
Yes.
Are her patterns?
All of her patterns are in there, and then her tools.
Good, good, good.
So, I'll put that in the what's new for you.
One thing to check out is she has a Sunbonnet Sue pattern that is, the pattern will never, ever, ever do it justice, but if you ever come in the store and you see it, it is so three-dimensional. All of the flowers on there, it's kind of a hall stopper.
Yes.
You know, for where it is. There's always, oh, wait, what is this? And so anyway, she has some really unique, very cool things. So
yes. And Carolyn Hutchinson from Carolyn's and Stitches, she came down for a visit. She actually gave us a few quilts to rehang up and brought some more patterns. So this one's Unhinged. We've had this one hanging in the store for a while. You guys have seen that one.
Super popular.
Super fast. And what's really nice is all of her patterns come in multiple sizes. She has figured out all the math, so you can make it in at least three sizes.
She is the math queen.
She's
It's terrible because I don't do that. It's like, this is the quilt and this is the size it makes.
Make more blocks.
Yeah.
Make more blocks.
Add a border. That's what I say every time. Do whatever you want to do. It doesn't matter. Oh, no, no. That is not Carolyn. She does baby, wall hanging, baby, twin, lap, queen, king.
She has them all.
She has them all. Yeah. She loves to do the math.
Yeah.
And she'll say all the time, oh, I need to sit down and work on a pattern. It's like, yeah, because it takes you 3 months to write it.
Yeah. You gotta calculate.
Have your little 10 key out. But anyway, she is does a really nice job. And then also, did you already hold up the back? And then also, she does all of the fabric requirements for all of those. You cannot imagine how much math that is.
It's awesome.
Crazy. And this pattern,
simply sashing.
If you're a beginner or you know a beginner or you're only a confident beginner and you kind of need a little bit of help with this, this is a really, really good pattern to have for a couple of reasons. One is, again, she's done all of the math for you. What the sizes and how much fabric you need.
Five sizes. Using yardage or pre-cuts, whether it's a 5-inch pre-cuts or the 10-inch squares.
Yeah. The other thing about this that makes this pattern unique and very special is the way that she puts her sashing on. Mm-hmm. She has a sashing trick here that is really, really nice, and it makes everything perfectly square, perfectly perfect, and it kind of basically makes that sashing part of the block rather than, you know, these big long things that you're doing that might shift things. So it's a really, really good pattern. And once you've made it, you could change it up a little bit and put something else, you know, in those little blocks. You could cut up a panel.
You'd be able to, cutting up a panel using orphan blocks.
Yeah.
On the run, it's just a beautiful braided table runner. Like, I lost it.
Table runner.
And then she did, when she reprinted it, she did put some other color coordinating pieces down there.
Of course she did.
Which is super great.
And so, how many sizes?
Just one. But 18 by 54.
Pretty good size.
It's pretty good. It's pretty good. And she also includes the quilt as you go instructions. So if you want to do it all at one time and not have to take it to the quilter, she also in here gives you a quilt as you go trick.
Really a nice trick.
Yeah. This is also, Rhapsody is also a really good beginner one.
Yeah.
This one is only in one size because she uses a jelly roll. So she uses a pre-cut. But super great. There are kids out there screaming. The kitchen helper. Just a really cool apron.
Really nice apron.
Yes.
And what's kind of fun about that is that she has this little thing, and you could really probably do this with any apron, but I love it that she puts it in hers, is there's a little button on the apron, and then you can take your little towel, and like Dunrovin has a little hook anyway, and you can just hook your little towel on your apron. You don't have to fling it over your shoulder anymore. Really nice. And then isn't there...
Wind farm. Now, this one is really, really pretty in real life.
Yeah.
I should go onto our website. I could go into her website and find some other pictures of Wind Farm. Wind Farm's really pretty. Again, five sizes. Yeah. And it's all like strip pieced and whacked and sewn back together. It's part of her magic series.
Yeah.
Which is quite impressive.
Really, so, really nice.
It's super cool. You can find Carolyn on Etsy at Carolyn's in Stitches. So if you are someone who prefers PDF patterns, that is where you can get a PDF version of all of her patterns.
Yeah.
Or email her and say, hey, can you do the math of this for me?
And do it.
She'll do it. She'll enjoy something to take her mind off of the other things she has to do.
Math is comforting for
yes.
her.
Yes.
And then, so let's see, Wednesday morning behind us we had framed up there, which was really, it's a fast pattern, a way to show off a really cool fabric. And the one that was behind us, maybe we could do a little insert reminder of what that quilt looked like. That particular one had a panel, and she just cut that panel up and kind of put it in order, and super unique, almost ombre-ish effect look to it, which was really cool. This is the exact same pattern,
so framed
just different color with this cool focus piece. She just had yardage that had a lot going on. And so you can see with those blocks, a lot of the blocks look a little bit different. But if you just have a really cool piece of fabric and you want to show off that fabric, that's what this is.
Yeah.
So it's just this kind of fun watercolor thing. It's just so funny that the same pattern, depending upon the fabric that you
looks
pick, it looks
so
different. There's this running joke all the time that, you know, I'll pick a pattern for somebody and go, oh, this one would be a nice one. They go, oh, yeah, but I don't like blue. It's like, you know.
Don't make it blue. There was a pattern that we had in the shop quite a bit, and I feel like it was just like star blocks. It was something super chill, but one side of the pattern was a quilt that was blue and white, and the other side was like yellow and green. It looked totally different.
Yeah.
And we had it in two places in the store, one with the blue one pointed out and one with the yellow one pointed out.
Yeah.
And we'd always show them. It's like, oh, I really like this one, but I'm not sure I want that so many blues. And what's the look at, oh, I like it, that maybe more green. You know, it's crazy to see it just in a different colorway.
Yeah.
It totally makes a difference.
All right. Whoosh. All right, well, we've cleaned up a bunch of area here. We're gonna, I guess we already know what box we're gonna open, right?
Yeah. Do you want to start with the Hoffman? Yeah. I just have a little Hoffman box.
A little Hoffman box, which means what? Maybe a couple of batiks?
Maybe a couple of batiks.
I can't imagine us buying only a couple of batiks.
I know.
That doesn't sound like us.
Christmas. It's weird to have a little box of Hoffman.
I know.
That's a leg. That's a foot.
That's I know what this is.
What is that?
I know what this is.
I can't believe you don't remember.
Oh, that's a pelican. I know what that eyeball is.
This is the one that you're going to make something. You want to hang this in your office.
Oh. I can't believe you don't remember what this
is. Oh my gosh, it's a Highland cow. I saw some patterns yesterday with Patty with this. She's like, oh, we have this one coming. It's a mama cow.
Let's see if you guys can guess what the rest of this is.
I can't believe you cannot remember.
She looks like an ostrich.
Or a flamingo.
I can't wait. All right, we're going to open the box.
We'll be right back.
Pass some things up. We'll be right back.
Okay.
I love a good Hoffman box. Really, 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 really good box. All right, so let's start with this one. So these are the Hoffman Call of the Wild panels. You guys have probably seen them before. Very realistic wildlife, yeah. And they are all 36 by 42, just large size panels that are really, really nice. So this pelican, which is fantastic.
Super awesome.
I know.
That's cool.
Isn't that neat? Fantastic. And we have a big bag in the shop. I can't remember which pattern it is. Can you remember off the top of your head?
No, I just know it's an Auntie's 2 pattern.
It's an Auntie's 2. And we did a great big bag and we used a panel like this that, you know, kind of shows that off. So there's fun things you can do. You can frame them. You can just put some quick borders on them. But we went ahead and went through. We're going to show you a couple of others.
But I went through our Bella Rosa pattern. So these are ones that you might have in your stash if you've done some Villa Rosa subscription packs with us, or maybe you don't, but these are really good ones. So for a horizontal panel like this one, there's two options. I love Honor. So Honor, this one has, they say yardage, so you see this yardage here on the ends, but I think it's a great place to put a panel and then just put a really fun ocean piece right there, whether it be fish or sky or whatever at the top and the bottom.
And if you look at the back, where you can just see the lines, you can see a little bit easier kind of how it goes. Mm-hmm. And the other thing that we always say is pick out the fabric that you think that goes with it and then just put in the note, say, hey, I'm wanting this to be my borders and do you think that that matches right? We do want you to
start it,
mm-hmm. you know, and then we can just swap it out and it's all okay, but at least we kind of know what you're thinking. And
otherwise, I'm going to put pink in there somewhere. Just telling you. and then if you like the idea of doing some Villa Rosa, this one is a panel with three pieces of yardage. So again, no pattern abbreviation like with Honor. This one is you get the panel and you have three other coordinates to go with it.
Super, super.
But again, how to use a horizontal piece.
Yeah.
And what's really nice is it's a 52 by 62, or they make it a little bit bigger to make it 55 by 74. So even starting with a horizontal panel, you can still make it, you know, scrunchable when you're on the couch. All right. The pelican. Beautiful.
Beautiful. Let's do this one next.
My kids call this the mama cow.
The mama cow.
I have it.
Because you have this framed.
On a whole wall. Yeah.
Oh, I love him.
Ah.
Oh, love it.
He's a handsome beast.
Yes, he is.
He's got something going on over here. Scenery, of course. Mm-hmm. I just love the way that they do that.
Yeah. Gosh, I love it. Again, horizontal, really nice. So you can do whatever you want. Put him in a bag, frame him.
And then
super easy.
Knowing that Brianna loves this kind of stuff and that this is what adorns her home, this is what she specifically picked out that she's going to do something to hang in her office.
Or my little book corner.
Oh, I love this! This is so cute!
It is so cute! Oh.
She's
got it going on.
I love it!
Right here.
I wish I was this cool.
I want those shoes. Look at those shoes.
Look at those. Awesome.
Yeah. I love it. She's pretty awesome. I want to know what's going on with her hair under that hat because my guess is she's got fabulous hair.
I thought this one would be super fun. Mm-hmm. So it's 31, but you can do fun little bright bits around the end and then the panel in the center. So if you do want to make it a quilt, I thought this was super fitting. Or I also liked this one. I don't know if this one's quite as groovy, but it's super simple. You could do a really fun, bring out some more purples or pinks or purple and blues. And frame it so you could really
it's just
turn
some
it.
Half log cabin book, so yeah. Super simple.
So really turn it into a little lovable quilt,
yeah,
if you needed to. But yeah, I just need to look at it. Makes me smile. All right. So those are the three newest.
And then just for fun, Brianna sort of went through them for you. Fish and chips is another one. Fairly popular. A lot of you guys might already have that one. Mm-hmm. Pots and pans. Another one.
Super
that's
fast
great
one.
With a panel. You can see on the back what they do. Super simple. And then this one is really nice. There's just a couple of piece blocks in the corner. Really easy. This one is called Daring Spirit. So another really nice one. And the Villa Rosa patterns, it's just brilliant. You know,
he does a
three box and the hard cards. They don't tell you all of the, you know, she's going to assume you know, quarter inch seam allowance, cut accurately, press as you go.
Yeah.
She's not going to go through all of the details with you. She's just going to say, make this block. And I mean, it's that much information. So,
yeah.
But anyway, really nice patterns.
And then, the other thing in the box is a gorgeous 1 inch check. Who doesn't need this in their life?
Yes, everybody needs it.
Whether you're doing a scarf for applique or you're just doing a dude quilt and
yeah,
you need it for a back or for a border. A nice green
tree line.
There you go.
Just a classic Hoffman piece.
Yep.
It's perfect this time of year with Christmas and people are always looking for more greens. And
yeah, that looked really good with the cow. Mm-hmm. And then two batiks.
Must have been colors we needed.
Yeah, must have been. So they're all, I bet you can see the texture on the blue better. They're the same texture, just a light blue on more of a royal blue, and then kind of a lighter purple on a true purple.
My guess is these might have been back order pieces that, you know, were meant to come with something else, but we'll put them back in the batik room. And really nice, good, clear colors.
All right, we'll get these out of the way, and I think I have a QT box sitting over there. Okay.
All right. It is QT. We always have really good stuff. I like QT fabrics.
Ooh, cowboy.
Western.
They do the best Western.
They do really, really, really good Western. Really good. I think it's been a little while since we've had.
I think so too.
Some Western stuff.
Ooh. Ooh, look at this marble iron.
And then that tool.
And some panels.
Panels. Oh, always a win. Look at that blue one.
What else? Get it? It's stuck in there. On the bottom of the box.
Those are pretty awesome.
Battles. Mm. All right, okay. I'm going to get some panels cut up. I'm going to get the plastic off and just show you up close.
All right,
super cute. So this one is really called Running Wild. It actually has three panels and 14 coordinates to go with it, and a couple patterns.
And Western fabric is super popular here. We have a big rodeo thing, and people that just love their horses, love their cows, and so super popular here.
Yes.
And so
it's pretty great.
Yeah, and it's kind of nice because I think right now we don't have
a full
collection of anything.
No.
We have little bits. You could probably find some saddles and some cowboy boots, and there's some things, you know, that you could probably find back there, but we don't have a current collection.
That is true. And also something really hard to find is cowgirls. And
cowgirls are hard.
I'll show you this. Oh, look at that.
Boom.
This is all cowgirls.
Oh, cowgirls.
That's right.
Not the Marlboro man.
Oh,
no.
Look at these girls.
They're fantastic. Now, is this, I didn't see you cut this. Is this running yardage?
It is running yardage. Uh-huh. So I cut this one so it's a full yard. So you can cut this one up, turn it into a really fun, simple quilt. I have an idea for you to cut it up for. Or just do a running piece. If someone needs one for the horse trailer. Because she's on the road, barrel racing or whatever she's doing.
What was your idea? Because my idea would, of course, be Hope Floats.
Hope Floats. I think Hope Floats would be super great. I think you could even adapt it to make a sash buster. I mean, Stars and Stripes.
Oh,
your squares, you would have to have a little border all the way around them to make it big enough, but it would be super great. But I also liked this one.
Oh.
Block Talk Stars. So this pattern looks super hokey. Like, I get that. How does this turn into this? But it totally could. So here's your block. So you have your center block. It can all be the same. It has all of the math for all your different size centers. But what's really cool about this block is in the inside, it makes a really cool star.
Oh, yeah.
Which
I think
is really appropriate when you're talking about Western.
And it's hard to see because of the fabric they picked on this one.
But
so it's hard to see
that.
Yeah.
That's a good one.
Super, super
that
cute.
That is a good one.
But there's also, so this one has a royal blue sashing. This one has a dark navy blue sashing. This is the cowboys.
Oh.
So they did separate it where it's all girls or all boys. I think that's still okay.
That's still okay.
I think we need some for the girls because.
Yeah. Sometimes it's not... just about the girls.
Yeah.
And that's okay.
That's okay. So this one I didn't cut. But it is, again, the same size, a full yard.
So if you order one, or if you order two, we'll leave them together, and then you can decide for yourself where you want to cut it apart.
So let's see.
Right.
There's oh, I see.
Right there.
Because of the way that it's, yeah. There you go. There's the boys.
Really nice.
So all you nice. Yellowstone really fans.
Nice. And yeah, Yellowstone fans. And it's nice because now QT is not going to like us saying this, but I'm just going to say for those of you guys that have the Northcott fabric, all of the Stonehenge stuff,
it coordinate really
would
good.
Coordinate perfectly with it. So
let us know in your notes. Yeah. Say, hey, I need some, I, you know, have a
I
black
a brown and a gray and a,
yeah.
I
really
want to,
right. Yeah. But yeah, so dark blue are the boys. Royal blue with girls.
And then there was another one.
And then there's a big one. This one's going to go super fast. Because I love this one too. There
you go. You already picked out an ostrich.
I know. And a horse. It's just crazy.
Oh.
Some wild Mustangs.
Gosh. That's fantastic. That is
I love it. They really did such a great job.
They really
did. And I love that they made it a little bit of an artistic look. So it's not like, oh, but the eyes aren't quite right. We've all seen those Western panels. Like, oh, it's a great horse, but I wish.
Yeah. Yeah.
So I really love that they did a more artistic, where it's almost a collage of color.
Beautiful.
But it is beautiful. They did a fantastic job.
Really, really nice.
So those are the panels for Running Wild. That's the pattern.
Yeah, pattern.
They just did, here's the, they did do a pattern, but I felt like this was easy to see, because the pattern is like a third of the size on the actual pattern cover. Yeah, so. So it takes, you're welcome, it takes the big panel, but again, you could turn it and use all the little cow, the cowgirls, the cowboys, you could do a piece, a chunk of fabric if you'd rather in there.
We could cut some kits for them.
You have a good, it doesn't take that much.
Because I think if we did, we should cut some kits just to
ensure you get the panel.
Because if the horse panel sells out instantly, you're kind of out of luck.
There are, I will look. And I will put, there are two Call of the Wild horse panels that are super cool. If I still have them. And even a unicorn. That is super majestic that you could do the same thing. And I'll put those with this collection. So it's all in one place. So if you miss out on this particular horse panel, there are, could be, another 36 by 42 inch horse panel you could put in the middle.
Okay.
So,
and then we'll go ahead and put some kits together for you. Just in case. And, the kits also include the binding and, if you guys remember, it's going to end up being 62 by 82.
Oh, that's good.
That's pretty good size. And so for a twin size bed, that would be great.
That's perfect.
And then the other thing too, just to remind you, when we do kits, we charge you for actual cut yardage.
Yeah.
So we don't round up or, you know, add in, oh, by the way, this was staff time or cut time or there's a lot of
kits. It's as if you went through and clicked every single one.
That's what we charge you.
Yeah. Doesn't cost you anything extra.
No, no. So we'll have, I think we'll probably cut three of those.
Okay.
Maybe four. We'll do four. We'll do four.
All right. So here
all right,
are
let's take a look at this.
Coordinates. Let me
pan across first. Beautiful colors. There's some really, really nice pieces in here that are really good. So we have, of course, the cow head on a beautiful blue. Yeah. And some little stars. And then this is the same piece on kind of a lighter blue. That's really nice. And then I'm going to jump ahead and show you exact same piece on the gold kind of color. So really pretty, nice pieces. And then this is really sweet. It's that nice blue. This would pair really well with the girl blue piece. So you can see it's just a really, it's almost a gingham-y. You see the print on there? And then, yeah, see, and look at with this. Yeah.
see the fabrics, these three together. So here's the girls here. Oh, am I like blocking your light? Are you good? Okay. And then this piece, and it's just such a sweet, I just love that print. And then you can see then this kind of blue tulle. That's really
this
nice.
This is even, I mean, it's a soft enough blue that if you are doing, there's a Western baby that's coming into your life. This would be really
It could totally
cute.
Be baby. It really
it's the
could.
Right shade of blue.
Yeah.
You can't tell if it's girl or boys.
No. No.
Riding.
It's just really nice. And then this is the exact same print, but it's got some tan on there.
Cute.
Equally nice. Just beautiful piece. And then some little blue hats and boots and stuff. And then we've got some saddles. And we've got the saddles with a blue background or with the brown background. Really nice. And then we've got these gorgeous horses.
And these are guys and gals.
They're together.
And some wild horses.
Wait, these are all... Oh, yeah, it is guys and gals. Yep, yep. Really, really. And not directional at all. They're going every which direction. So, and then this one is, so you can see that there's blue and brown in both of these. This one is primarily kind of the tan background with little bits of blue. And this one is primarily the blue sky background. So just a little bit different colorways.
Awesome.
Yeah, really, really pretty. And then there's these. So here is another tulle. Kind
that's
of a
really
tulle
rich
leather. I really rich, and you can see how it matches that same brown color. And then this, it's the same thing. It's still tulle, but sort of multicolored. Really unique. It almost has a, if tulle and paisley had a baby.
Yep, that's what you'd get.
And then, of course, barbed wire,
awesome.
Which is not for horses.
No, we can jump
but,
that.
Yeah, but... really, really nice. So blue on tan or kind of a denim-y blue on dark blue.
Yeah.
All right.
Love it.
Okay, we'll put these away. And then we have, I think that those two big boxes might be Notions boxes. So we'll take a quick peek. Okay, before we open this box, we want to mention a little something. The website, let's see, we did that challenge using our sagebrush fabric, the sagebrush batik that we did with Hoffman. And so the main reason that we did that is people kept saying, well, gosh,
I need inspiration.
What'd you make with it? So so we have quite a few. Anna did it as a YouTube, and we did it as a YouTube for a couple of reasons. One is that it's a way easier way to be able to vote. All you have to do is comment. So watch the YouTube video, comment on who gets your vote. Yes. Everybody will win a prize. It's just how great
how
the prize
big
is.
The prize.
But everybody will win a prize. So vote on your favorite. There are only winners. And take a peek at all of those. And the other reason that it's nice to do it on a YouTube and comment is so that you get used to how you comment on those videos, because that's how our YouTube live bra auction will go, is you will have to be able to comment while you're watching. So we want to...
Perfect way to practice.
Perfect way to practice. Comment as many times as you would like. And then, and so that is on our YouTube channel, and it's also on our website?
Yes. So I still have the Sagebrush Batik Challenge on our website. I will also put the video there. I'll also do a drop-down vote. If you're part of our book club, you know what that looks like. Just in case, there's some of you like, oh my gosh, I'm not doing that. I
can't do it.
I'm not going to learn one more
stressful.
Thing. I will do it so you can vote there too. So we can,
perfect.
You guys will all participate. You'll have to watch it online and then vote right there. But it'll all be together, so.
And the link for the video will be on our website.
Yes, they can watch it right there on our website.
Okay.
And then you have until the end of the day tomorrow to vote for your favorite one, and then we will show it at Fabric Chat. We will rattle off our winners.
Fantastic. All right, good. And speaking of book club, just for a second, so that's the other thing that, just for fun, we've talked about this multiple times, that, you know, we're always looking for a good movie. We don't want to waste our time watching a bad movie, so we hear from friends what movies to watch. And same thing with books. We don't want to waste our time with a bad book. So I have to tell you, I got myself into a little bit of trouble. Again, as usual, as I do. But I had mentioned to you guys on Wednesday that I broke a tooth Tuesday night. I was able to get into an emergency dental appointment. Uh-huh. It was a 3.5-hour dental appointment.
Was it because he worked you in? Because he was in and he was out and he was in and
he was out. In and out. And yeah, so a lot of it was me sitting there, you know, waiting. But a lot of it was waiting for things to dry and things to do things and things to numb. And
I've been one of those appointments also. And it was great. I took a nap. He was like, I can't. No, people don't sleep here. I was like, dude, I have three kids at home.
So I was going to sleep.
A best way. Like, I lived down the lines a little bit. Turn on the music. I don't even care.
Warm blanket.
It's like, this is my nap. Take as long as you need. Oh, there's an emergency. That's okay. I can wait. Yeah,
it's fine.
I have until 2:30. So yeah, I got plenty of time.
Okay, well, that is not quite my life. But listening to the book on tape is. And, I mean, not on tape, but Audible.
Yeah.
So I really like the Audible because I'm always doing something, you know, whether it's sewing or cleaning or driving or whatever, yeah. Putting fabric away. But to sit with a book it is harder for me to do. But so personally, I prefer Audible. Well, I don't know how the voting is going for what we're voting on, but The Unhoneymooners is one of them, right?
Oh, yes. Is it funny?
It is so
funny. The person who nominated this movie was so hilarious. Funny.
Laugh out loud. So that's the thing. So here, I'm listening to it, and same thing.
In the dentist's office?
You know, and I'm laughing. It's like, are you joking?
Sorry.
I mean, if you can laugh even while somebody's, like, cutting into your mouth, it's funny. I'm going to warn you, it's a little bit like a Hallmark movie, kind of. I mean, it's that whole, you know.
Sure.
But
it's good.
It's funny. Mm-hmm. It's super, super funny. So,
good.
Anyway, highly recommend. I am not entirely done with it yet, but it's one that's been hard to put down. So,
I just really good. Finished a young adult book. It was one that I took camping with us. I had to finish it in audio form because I no longer had time to sit and read a book. But yeah. It was said, Dead Girls Can't Tell Secrets.
Oh.
And it was really good. It's a young adult, so there's no, I think there was two things that she gave her boyfriend a kiss. So it was super PG. And it wasn't, what happened was, and you find this out in the very first chapter, which I love. You're like in it. So, this sisters, they go to the same school. Her younger sister fell off this cliff. And they couldn't tell if it was suicide, but everyone thought, no way. She was happy. She was great in school. There was no reason for that. And so her sister's trying to figure this out because someone had to have hurt her. Because why was she up there? Why would she have just fallen off? And so you go through this whole thing of her joining different things in school that her sister was a part of and this kind of growing thing that
she drew.
Yeah. And it was really good. And it was teenagers. So it was, you know, they were doing different things and different groups in school. And she learned a lot about her sister. And it ended really good. And so it's a really good one. So if you're looking for a young adult that's a little bit of a mystery, a little bit of a thriller, it's a really good one. And super
very
clean.
Very clean.
No gore, no blood, no bedroom
graphic
scenes.
No bedroom scenes.
It's very good. I think Eliza would like it. I'm going to let Brittany see it. I have it in book, so I can even give it to Eliza so she can read it. And I think she would like it. I think it also makes someone that age think differently. Instead of just assuming he's bad, there's a couple of things like, why don't you just ask?
Right.
Why don't you just, then you wouldn't have done all this.
Yeah.
But there are certain things, and I think it would be good for her to know that not every friend is who you think they are.
Yeah.
Yeah. So it was good. It was a very good one.
Good. And I like young adult. And I sometimes don't even realize it until afterwards. Like, oh, that's in the young adult section. Oh,
yeah.
But there's
and it was a super, and it was a super fast read and
quick read.
And it always has, you learn lessons throughout a young adult, I think.
Yeah.
Because they are wanting them. But it was a really good one, too.
Yeah. Oh, good. Good. Yeah. And then also, before I put these away,
Oh, for panels.
I just wanted to mention, we saw so many panels this time. Just as a nice resource is this book. And there's all kinds of things in there that are kind of cool with some different ideas. Many of the panels in this book, of course, you can no longer get. I mean, that's part of the problem is by the time somebody makes the samples, photographs them, puts them in the book, they are obsolete, but it still will give you some nice inspiration for things that you might be able to do with some panels. So if you like panels, I am a panel fan. Love, love, love panels. I love that it takes out most of the hard work for me, and then I just have to find a few fabrics that'll go with it.
And it's nice that it's big panels or little panels or block panels. And also, if it's fabric you just don't want to cut up,
Yeah.
They talk about it all.
And then the other thing I want to mention, we keep saying we're going to do a quick video about this, and maybe we'll get to that really quick, but sometimes you'll get a panel that seems a little bit, you know, and it might be that when it's printed, it could be that the way that that fabric is on the roll, something got stretched or, you know, something happened with that, and it looks a little bit weird, and you have to press it. That's all you have to do is you just have to press it. Get out all of your best press or spray bottle of water, whatever you prefer. Mm-hmm. Get it kind of wet. Pin it almost like you're blocking. For those of you guys that have done knitting and crocheting and you know how to block a sweater, it's the same thing. You know, when you block a sweater, you're going to get it wet. You're going to lay it all out. You're going to pin it, put something on it, let it air dry, and your sweater comes out perfect. Sometimes you have to do that same thing with the panel. And I just want to mention, we have a video about this. This is that, if you can't find it on the website, creative grid flannel. Creative grid flannel. It's hard because people, it's like, what do you call that? This is what it's called. Creative grid flannel. This is a perfect 2-inch grid. It is 54 inches wide. The design walls that we use out at the retreat centers and in our sewing studios and here at the shop, we use that foam core insulation board, and we wrap our boards with 2¼ yards of this, and it works out just perfect. But if you just have like a little bit of leftover, or if you just want to get a yard, I would actually say probably a half a yard. 18 inches. No.
What are you trying to do?
I might be able to help. I don't know. What are we making?
Wrap your ironing board.
Oh yeah.
To put it on your ironing board. Maybe just measure and see if you need a half a yard, 3/4 of a yard or whatever. Mm-hmm. But it's 54. So that's probably the length that you'll need. You just need a little bit. And you don't even have to go crazy and make a cover. Just drape it over.
Yeah.
And then that way, when you are, this happens to be a little remnant piece. So we have a bunch of these. And if you do a half a yard, we're probably going to end up giving you more because we'll get rid of these first. But just put that on. And then that way you can really kind of have a little guideline as you are pressing to get that panel straight. So
It works really well. So I have one. Robert actually made me a flat cover. So instead of it being, you know, tapered at the end, it drove me crazy because it was hard for me to press quilts. So I have a handy husband who made a little topper. And I framed it in that. It makes it so easy when you're doing like crumb cake or 2-bits because you can kind of like guess measurement. Like, oh, I'm making, you know, 15-inch blocks and then I'll sew it all together in the end. And then I can kind of, oh, I'm right on. Oh, it's a little bit bigger, but that's okay.
Yeah.
Because with the crumb cake, you kind of just crumb it together and then square it up at the end. But it makes it things really easy.
It's really nice.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
All right.
Okay. Enough of that.
Big old Notion box. And I think a lot of this is probably reorder stuff.
Probably reorder from our Notions wall. So maybe nothing super new. Let's see.
Yeah.
Tube turners.
Yeah. This is the bring the noodles.
Oh, let me go for grab noodles. It. Yeah. Are you going to grab the quilt?
Yeah.
If you don't have this in your sewing studio, everybody should have this ready to go because it's one of those things that all of a sudden you need it. And then what are you going to do? It's for these. Yeah, all of your little noodles or straps or tubes for whatever you're doing.
It's a fun kid project. So it's something that you can do a race at Thanksgiving while we're waiting for pie to be cut. We can race to see how many kids can do so many noodles in 5 minutes.
Yes.
They can do all the work for you. So it's really, really fun.
Yes. And then we got more of these. I'm wondering if we had some on back order because we were out for a little while and then now we have more. So this is that white iron away pen. So if you're doing something on dark fabrics, it's the one that Tracy uses for her sashiko, which is really nice. A lot of these things we just got because there's more pink things we're putting together. Brianna is going to do a new baby package. We've talked about this a lot, things that she loves, and we have some grandmas out there that are waiting for her basket of things that is going to be auctioned off at the website.
Mm-hmm.
Bra auction. And then we're also going to do a couple of pink Notions kits. And then I'm doing one of my favorite things, which is kind of fun. So anyway.
So pink pencil with pink lead. Pink thread. This is a pink chalk pencil. This one is great. So
it is a good
This one is just a regular a click pencil that's chalk, so it'll either rub off or you can actually erase it off. It says you can erase it with just a fabric eraser, or it goes water, but it's super great. This one's white.
Maybe I got white. And I got all the colors. Did I love white? This one. So I might have all of them. I'm at the top of the box. Oh, yeah. See, what's this one?
This one says pink.
Oh, this is the eraser. I know, we'll keep looking. But it's good. It comes in white, pink, and blue chalk lead. It's super fantastic. I have the blue one and the pink one. And it is fantastic. Even if you just want to make it, your line just a little bit bolder. I use it for everything, whether it's machine embroidery, marking for sewing, marking for microwave bowls. It is awesome. Because it is a hard chalk, so it's not gonna like dust off. It'll stay on while you're stitching and everything. So I love this. And then yeah, you can just erase it off or it will wash off. And then I did get some of the really cool erasers. And it's just an eraser stick.
Because it's way cuter and than like a pencil pink. Eraser.
Yeah, who wants one of those big bulky things? Those are for the school kids.
Yeah, these are adult erasers.
Oh, here's the pink one. What is the pink one? So this is pink chalk.
Oh, and then see, so same thing. So your eraser will just come out and you can just keep, yeah.
Mm-hmm. It's great. So pink chalk, white chalk. It's great. There might be a blue one in here, but it's really good. It's one of my favorite ones.
I can see.
I like it a lot. The hot hammer. This is one we had for a while. Hot hammer comes in a couple sizes. This is our favorite size.
It is.
Because you can do everything, curved edge, an inverted corner, a corner, and you can only press so far if you're hemming something. So to get the one that's 14 inches long, I can't press 14 inches straight. So I like the little one. It's affordable nice. And it's not a one trick pony. She does quite a bit.
And it's also one of those things that once you have it and you've used it, it's like, how have I sewn all these years without one of these in my life? So
they're awesome. Whatever it is, it's like this funny heavy duty, almost like felt pad thing.
Yeah.
It totally does not warp under the heat of your iron, no matter how long it's on there.
Yeah. Super nice. Purple Thang. And so Purple Thang. So this is a perfect quarter inch mark up there. And so you can use that for measuring. You can also use it for stuffing. It's a stuffing tool or to your points just right. And then it's also a bodkin. So you can loop something through there. See the little eye there? If you want to put in like elastic in your pajama pants or something like that.
That's really good. The thread cutter pendant. So it is just there's like a little rotary cutter in there, but you can barely tell. If you're a hand quilting, sashiko, embroidery, and you're on a plane or on a train or in a car, you can cut your thread for you and you just wear it on a chain. There is antique gold or antique silver. Antique silver looked like it's a polished gold one. I don't know. I wouldn't say it's very silver, but the antique gold is a little darker, more antiqued. The antique silver is just a little bit lighter. Both beautiful, both awesome. Super cool.
Domed threaded needle case, if you know, you know. This is one of my favorite things. We've demonstrated this multiple times, but it'll hold your threaded needle. I think it holds 10. Does it hold 10 or 8? I can never remember. I ask every single time. It's either 8 or 10.
I think it's 10.
Does it say?
No. It's 10.
10.
It's 10.
Yeah, and so if you don't want to thread all of your needles, whether it's for hand quilting or for embroidery or whatever, it'll hold whatever thickness of needle or thread you're using. You can wait for somebody to come over who has those nice little eyes and they can thread all of your stuff for you, which is super, super nice.
Okay, some more marking utensils. These are water soluble pencils. So it's not chalk, it's actually a lead, so it does have to be washed out. But in this package, you get blue, pink, and white all in one. We actually go through a lot of these. These are a really nice one to have. Just sharpen it with a regular eraser, but wash away. And this is also a wash away pen. We have fine point pens that are really, really great. This is just a thick one. So if you're doing bags and you really want to see a big old chunky line because you want to make sure you stop when you're supposed to stop or you're sewing right on the line you're supposed to stay on, this is just a thick chunky tip versus a nice fine point tip and a water soluble pen.
Omni grid. This must be blades. So
blades. I have some Quilter Select blades. So 45 millimeter replacement blades for your Quilter Select rotary cutter.
Oh, Oh, the glow tape.
Ordered this again.
Yeah.
Was it people who ask for this? Yep. So glow tape you put on your ruler and it marks where your cutting line is. I have to tell you, I prefer the wet erase marker, but we've had people that have asked about this, and that's how you use your glow tape.
You can also stack your glow tape to create an edge.
Yeah.
If you're cutting the same thing over and over again.
Some seam rippers. Oh, these are kind of fun. So the bobbin toppers, people were asking about these to have something just to be able to put your bobbin with your thread, especially if you're using like specialty threads. And then
filter select rotary cutter. I also found we have single replacement blades or in packs of five replacement blades.
And then did we also get the book for this ruler? No.
No, but I have the book in stock.
The Quilters Select Dresden ruler. It is a really cool book, really modern take, kind of fun. So this one is the 18 degree ruler, and then this one is the 30. So it just is different sizes for your Dresden. Oh, is she going to go? She's going to go get it so that you can see it. But Dresden plates and... Grandmother's Flower Garden, the Hexies, all of those things have really made a comeback. The things that we think of as being fairly, maybe old-fashioned or vintage, kind of cool and something fun to do with your fabric.
Susan's totally modernized it. So there's some of the quilts on the back. But these are all using her rulers.
Yeah.
So she really takes the time to explain her rulers, how they work, so that you can use it on your own if you want to experiment. If you're wanting to do any of these patterns, she really does a really good job illustrating how to make it.
Yeah. And what's kind of nice is having that wedge to know that it's the right size wedge so that it goes around the way that it's supposed to. And all you do, you can see that once you cut, so she shows you the directions on the back. Once you've cut that wedge, you're just going to sew it that way. And then you end up with that point. You sew all of the blades together. And then it's just the way that you want to sew that down. And people just, you can sew it down by hand and applique it, or you can sew it down by machine. It doesn't matter. Super, super simple. So they come with the directions and a really fun thing to do. If you have just a whole bunch of weird leftover, you know, funny fabric bits and you want to do something with it, it's a fun thing where you can just make a little bit. And then when you have enough to do something fun with, then you can put something together that is kind of cool because they look really cool scrappy, I think.
Yeah.
I like those in place.
Some more rulers. So I think it was Wednesday. We got some Quilter Select rulers. We got 10, 12, 6 inch squares. Here's a 6.5 inch square. The 6 and 6.5 is one of my favorite sizes. I mean, I love a 6x12, hands down always, but it's nice to have like a 6.5, an 8, a 6, somewhere in there where you can cut your own 5-inch squares, trim up a smaller block, and it's a little more manageable. Especially on that
of retreat. All of those years that I was sort of struggling with two rulers and I did everything with just two rulers. And then you go out into Pa's shop and you see that he has drawers of every single size of screwdriver, every single size of metric screwdriver, every single size of Phillips screwdriver.
And every length.
And every length. Just drawers and drawers of them. It's like, really? You can just like skip a size? No.
Yeah.
So now, you know, my ruler wall is impressive, even though it's
a minute.
Yeah. Compared to his.
Robert always used to say, well, that's how you have to buy it. You have to buy them in a set. But no, you don't.
No, you do.
You have to buy them in a set. Well, so when we go to the store and you can buy one, two, I'm like, why is this one so special? You can buy him by yourself. What is this? And he's like, I don't know what that is. I don't use that. Okay. He's going to die on that.
Whatever.
Taking that secret to the grave. Nope, you have to buy him in a set. Those single ones, I don't even know what that is.
I'm just going to start saying that.
You have to buy him in a set.
You can't buy one piece of fabric. No, you have to buy the whole
set.
You have to buy it in a set.
One piece. I don't know what's that. More of these.
We keep selling out of these. These are
adorable.
Yeah, we've got quite
a few.
So six more. We need to start ordering them in like, you know, two boxes.
I didn't know so many people wanted a pink tomato.
We love these. We ran out again. So yeah. Get one now or hopefully next week they'll be back.
Yeah. The No Math Flying Geese ruler. Fantastic.
Yeah.
It's a really cool trick where you make 4-in-1 and all the math is on the ruler. So if you lose the little paper that tells you how to use it, no worries. It's all on here.
Yeah.
And you can do it really good. But
yeah,
it's a super really fast way. No bias.
Yeah, really good. Really good. So, all right, that's it for that box.
That's it. That's it.
All right, we're going to clean all this up, and then we have another box over there we're going to open.
Yes.
And we'll be right back.
All right.
We have lots of boxes left. Yes. So we have this great big huge one. We have one from the Featherweight company. It still has fabric left. So I feel like I've been at this for hours already.
I know.
You too?
It's been hours, right?
Chase's title is just
too. It's a long one. This is not what I thought. What is this, Mom? It's Hot Wheels.
Hot Wheels.
Let me get this out of your way.
What is that? So I thought that this was going to be another door banner.
Oh my gosh. Wyatt's going to love it. I don't know what this is, but
I love the box.
Of course, Riley Blake, they always do the coolest box ever.
Made to race.
Oh, and the box opens like this.
It was a quilt. That's your quilt kit. Look at that.
Oh, that is cute.
I love that.
Oh my goodness.
Has a full color pattern, has the pattern and all of the fabric.
To get a panel
quilt ends up 55 and a half by 62 and a half.
Oh my goodness.
Cute.
And that's it.
Yeah.
Dang. That box is awesome.
That box is fantastic. Plus, you could put all of your little cards in there.
Yeah. What a great way to re-gift your quilt.
And
so here's your pieces.
Pattern. Full color pattern.
Hot Wheels in every color. There's even the Barbie cars in there.
What?
Don't tell the boys. It's fine. They don't know. It's Ken's car.
Hey. Okay.
Girls can't drive. Black and white check. And really cool Hot Wheels. Hot Wheels racing. Awesome. Here's your panel. All right. We don't have just the panel.
Can't buy just panel.
You have to get.
Don't ask about the panel.
You have to get it like this. But you have to see this.
Oh. Bum, bum, bum.
That's awesome. Look at the lightning. I didn't even notice the lightning. That is fantastic.
That's pretty good. That's pretty awesome.
That was worth opening up.
That was good.
Yes.
Fun, fun, fun. Not very many. I think there's
not
10.
Enough. That could be a frenzy. If we sell out really fast, we will contact Riley Blake and see if there's any left.
Yeah.
Because dang.
That's pretty cute.
Pretty fantastic.
Okay. They do such a nice job with packaging, I just have to say.
They do.
I think it matters, you know, to me.
But if you think that Riley Blake's kits are a little expensive, I mean, they do. They put in the work.
Yeah.
Because how cool is that?
And also their patterns are full color patterns.
Yeah.
Easy, full size patterns. Easy to make. So
that box is.
The box is cute. Which is really nice. Okay.
Bam. Yeah. And what a great way to gift that.
Gift your little
so you made.
Cars in there.
Yeah. And then they can put all their cars in one safe place.
Yeah.
All right, here is the Featherweight Shop box.
So we sell the stuff, all of the Featherweight supplies. We have, your quarter inch feet. We have the reproduction cases. We have the lube, the oil, the pins, all kinds of stuff.
Mm-hmm.
And you can go to, it's in its own little section?
Yep, I'll put it in the suit for you.
Also in there, we have a box. That includes a manual and a link for a video. And Jordan is on this video with you going through exactly what to do. And you're even helping. You're pointing
it's
at
seeing this real thing. It's and, pretty, a pretty
yeah,
great
video. You can take your featherweight. And you just need a towel and a couple of tools. He tells you at the very beginning what all you need. And then everything is in this box. And then you can go ahead and service your machine. Because there's how many places that you have to oil it? Like 45 or 54 or 120?
A lot.
A whole lot. And it includes this book.
Yes. And this is just a maintenance book. So it goes through, I think, both the 221 and the original.
And,
And it's really nice. It's a flip book, so it stands up on itself. Really good illustrations. So this comes in that box. The box comes with all of your oils. all those things, your belts, yeah. all that bit, plus of this. Or if you're like, oh, I have all of that, or I just want to know how to maintain it better, get yourself a maintenance book.
Yeah.
And it can go through it and you can see why things are, it breaks things down. If you have a husband who really wants to help you and you're afraid, this will make you less afraid.
Yeah.
If he follows this.
Yeah.
If he reads instructions.
Yeah.
It's great.
And then new light bulbs. We've been out of these, so some of you guys have been waiting for these, so we'll, Tracy will get these on the way to you. So what's super nice about the light bulb is they're no longer the incandescent. What do they call that?
Yeah, the ones that burn.
They're all LED. So way brighter, and they don't get hot.
They don't get hot, which means that little capsule that protects you from your light bulb won't get flaming hot either. So it's a win-win all the way around.
Yeah. A little quarter-inch strip with a blade, which is kind of nice.
Mm-hmm.
Did you already show all of these? And then a maintenance logbook, which is kind of nice. Yeah. The other thing that it's not in this box, but we have in stock is the little green
original
manual. I mean, reproduction. Looks the same.
Yeah. The maintenance log is also good for your regular machines too. So if you are bad about keeping it in the shop or when you last put it in there, you can put all your machines in here, not just your little one.
Yeah.
Did you tell about the deodorizer spray?
I did not. I love this stuff. Mm-hmm. I love this stuff. So those funny smells, I mean, it's a real unique smell. It's the smell of a button box and the smell of a featherweight case. It's that old, old, oh my gosh, where has this been stored case. So that deodorizer is super strong. It's all natural. It has some peppermint in it. It's really, really nice. You can spray the inside of that box and it takes that smell away. I have to say that I have used that deodorizer spray on other things. If something is, you know, has got some sort of an odor for some reason, that deodorizer spray is really nice because, it's all natural. So it's meant to be used on, you know, vintage fabrics and vintage linings. And so it's a really nice spray to have around.
Yeah. Just says all natural. I don't say what's in it, but.
Well, it is. If they tell you what's in it,
you're going to make your own.
And make their own. Yeah. And,
but it is all natural. So it's going to be your essential oil smells.
Yeah.
But
you
just to know what concoction of.
Yeah. Smells good.
All right.
All right. And then we still have fabric.
Yes. And then I have a teaser of it. So I have this, bag. Mm-hmm. And then I have a Michael Miller box that I'm sure matches this. If not, I'd be surprised. Fairy Frost. And we thought Fairy Frost would be good because those of you that are trying to get Christmas stuff done,
you need this.
You need
all of the blingy.
Sweet. Stuff.
And probably in there is the glow in the dark stuff, I'll bet.
Oh, I hope so.
Because that's the other, that's who does the glow in the dark fabric is Fairy Frost. So.
Okay. I can't get the other one to cut it.
Well, you're not going to like the sound. We're going to stop.
I do have to tell you, yesterday we were ordering fabric for you guys, or Wednesday. Thursday. Anyway, sometime this week.
One day.
We were sitting down with Patty. Lewis and Irene, we've seen a bunch of them. The cutest Halloween fabric is coming.
All that glows in the dark.
We won't see it till June. Mark your calendar. June. Mm. We will have the cutest glow in the dark.
Oh, good.
So
we'll forget.
See, we will forget by then.
We act like, and then we'll be all surprised.
Write it down for us and you can remind us.
Oh, yeah, you said.
Hey.
Yeah,
we
don't know.
I'm excited for it.
Yeah, because the stuff that we ordered this week will be here, next June.
June.
That's why we can never remember.
No. But if you write it down, maybe you can remember. All right, I'm going to get the other Michael Miller box open, get all this plastic off, and then we'll show you.
Okay.
Fairy Frost. I love it. A few new ones, maybe, when I put them in for you.
Do you think there's new ones?
Well, I don't know. When I put them in, I couldn't find a previous SKU number for it. So I feel like we've had all these before.
These are just classic.
Fairy Frost is as old as fossil fern.
It is. It's been around for a long time. Longer than we have been around.
Yeah.
And so if you just need that little bit of blingy stuff, you know, if you're working on some Christmas things and you want a little something sparkly, or it doesn't have to be Christmas, just bling for any reason. This is your all of your bling ones. So we'll go through and show you the colors, but at least you can kind of see what they are.
And these ones are kind of shimmer.
Shimmer?
And then you can totally see the sparkle happening.
Yes. Okay. We'll show you the difference. So I'm going to tell you the names of these. And if you look at these, I don't know if you can show up close. Yeah. So this is a little bit more almost coppery, and this is gold. And then this one is silver, and this is more like platinum. And let me just tell you the name. So this one that I think is more coppery is called Bling. This one that's more gold is called Twinkle. This one is Zirconian. And then this one is Glimmer. And so, yeah, you can really see a difference. Very silvery and very platinum-y. And then this is just fantastic. Just diamond sparkle on kind of that gray background. And this one is called Moon. And then this is kind of the end of the glitter. So here, there is no glitter on any of these. These are all the shimmers. And this one is called Onyx. This one is called Natural. This one is called Snow.
Beautiful.
And it really is beautiful. This one is probably one of our top sellers. This one is called Icing. And it kind of is sort of a pale ivory. And then this little bit of kind of yellow. This one is... Oh, yeah, this one is called Icing, and this one is called Ivory. Isn't that funny? Because I think of this as, am I wrong? I feel like I think that this is more ivory, and this is, has a little yellow tinge to it.
I agree with that.
But they are calling this ivory.
This is buttercream.
Yes.
With a little extra
buttercream
vanilla.
Buttercream icing. That's right. And this is the glow in the dark. Woo!
She's and white that glows in the dark. You have to make sure you keep her in a safe place because you will think that is white on white fiery frost until she glows.
Ask us how we know that will happen.
Then you'll realize you're...
Dang it, what's wrong with this?
Mixed match white and white is a great idea until you turn the lights off.
Only for 20 minutes.
Yeah.
It glows for 20 minutes and then whatever.
You got to recharge it.
It doesn't
matter. Yep.
Yeah.
All right.
All right. That was a lot. I feel like that was a whole bunch. We've been at it for 4 hours now. And so now there's even people heckling us from behind. We should just turn that camera right now. Then he would run.
It was a cute dog thing I sent him. It's here. I'll have to show you. They don't know why he gave me that funny look. It was a dog.
All right.
We
happy shopping. And be sure and go vote for the
sagebrush.
And we'll do a quick little recap for you of all of the things that we saw. Kudos to those of you guys that hung in for the whole thing. And then be sure and go and vote on the sagebrush, the item that you like the best, so that they win bigger prizes.
And make sure you sign up for a newsletter. So if you're new to us and you haven't done it yet, sign up for just the basic newsletter.
You don't get very many.
No, maybe quarterly, and that might be pushing it. So,
twice a year.
But we're going to put one out probably next week sometime going over the bra auction and dates you need to know about and things that are happening.
Future events.
When our 12 Days of Christmas is going to start.
You'll need the newsletter for when things are available for retreats.
Yes.
That's not until January. So
we'll have a little snippet in that in the newsletter. Yeah. So sign up for that if you're new, and then you'll watch for that to come through. All right.
All right. See you next week.
Bye.
Bye.
Thank you for watching our video. We invite you to leave a comment, hit the like button, or better yet, subscribe to our channel so you never miss an episode. You can also visit our Instagram, Twitter, Facebook, or Pinterest pages, or find all of those things and our online store at fabricpatch.net.